أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we ask for His forgiveness. We also send our salam and salutations upon the beloved Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family and his friends. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless each and every one of us, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us in Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen. Today, insha'Allah ta'ala, I wanted to speak about a very, very beautiful story. This is the story of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu's good deed that was done in secret. And this is a story that has been narrated to us by Umar radiallahu anhu. He said that during Abu Bakr's reign, when Abu Bakr was Khalifa, there was something odd that he used to do every single day. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he would come to the masjid for Salatul Fajr, he would lead the prayer, and then after Salatul Fajr, he would go towards the outskirts of Medina for a while, and then he would return. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, Abu Bakr would do this on a daily basis. And Umar, he said, I became very curious about this. And Umar radiallahu anhu was very curious about the deeds that Abu Bakr used to do. As you know that Umar radiallahu anhu used to compete all the time with Abu Bakr, although Abu Bakr would always come out on top, but they always competed, subhanAllah. And therefore this made Umar radiallahu anhu very curious, what is Abu Bakr doing on a daily basis? So he said, one day I decided to follow him. So he said, after Salatul Fajr, I waited for Abu Bakr to leave the masjid, and when he left, he said, I followed Abu Bakr behind him, at a good distance so Abu Bakr wouldn't notice. He said, we went really far away, so outside of Medina, in the outskirts, towards the desert, opposite his home, meaning opposite of Abu Bakr's home. And he said that we came across this old house, very small old house, it was like a hut. And he said that I hid at a certain place so, you know, no one could notice me. He said, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he went inside this house and he stayed there for a while. He said that the sun had risen, it was getting hot, so I would say maybe a couple of hours, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu spent time in that house, and then after that, Abu Bakr came out and went back towards Medina. So Umar said, I was very curious, so I decided to go and knock on the door. He said, I knocked on the door, and this very old, fragile lady opened the door. He said, Assalamu alayki, you know, what is your situation? The old lady said, well, I am very, very old, I am weak, I'm frail, and I am blind. And she said that I have many, many orphans in the house. So Umar saw a lot of children running around in the house, and they were orphans. And they were probably her children's children, maybe her children passed away, Allahu A'lam, but they were orphans living with her. And she said that there is no one there to help me. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he asked this lady, who was that man who just came here? She said, by Allah, I don't know who he is. لا يذكر لي اسمه أبدا. He has never told me his name. And then Umar radiallahu anhu asked, what does he do? She said, well, he comes to my house every single day. He cleans my house. He washes our clothes. He grinds the wheat. He bakes the bread and he makes the breakfast. Now, subhanAllah, can you imagine those deeds or those things that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was doing? He would clean their house, he would wash their clothes, he would grind the wheat, he would bake the bread, and he would make the breakfast. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he asked, every day? She said, by Allah, every day, may Allah reward him. Again, he was just amazed. And He said to her, "Do you pay him anything?" She said, "By Allah, I don't pay him anything. He doesn't take anything from me." Subhanallah, upon hearing this, Umar radiallahu anhu, he began to cry. He said, "Ata'abta al-khulafa ba'daka ya Abu Bakr." You have exhausted the khalifas who will follow you, ya Abu Bakr. Subhanallah, how can a man who was a leader of the Muslim Ummah, the Khalifa of the Muslim Ummah, the Amir of the Muslim Ummah, spends that much time doing something that you would think a slave would do, subhanallah, yet he would spend that time helping this widow, this old, fragile, blind woman and her orphans, subhanallah. He would do this on a daily basis, keeping that deed secret between him and Allah, not telling anyone about this, not telling Umar radiallahu anhu, his closest companion at the time, not telling maybe his family, not telling that lady who he is, subhanallah, keeping that between him and Allah. Wallahi, we would have never known this narration if it wasn't for Umar following Abu Bakr. Imagine the other secret deeds that Abu Bakr probably has or had and we don't know about it, subhanallah. This is a massive, massive lesson that we learn from this story. We learn a huge lesson, and that is a secret deed that you can do that only you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know about. So inshallah ta'ala, let's find a deed, a good deed that we can do that only you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know about. And of course, keep this deed according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning don't do something that is an innovation and against the sunnah. Do something good that is according to the sunnah, inshallah. And there's so many things that you can choose from. There could be in a form of sadaqah. It could be, you know, a type of dhikr that you are doing. It could be, you know, a few nawafil prayers or something. You know, during tahajjud time, a certain deed that you are doing at that time that no one else have to know about, subhanallah. But think of something that you can do that only you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know about it. This shows the sincerity between you and Allah. This shows the sincerity that you are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are so many things, even Bilal radiallahu anhu, he had a deed that later on was exposed to us, of course, by Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard the footsteps of Bilal in paradise, and he asked Bilal, "Ya Bilal, what are you doing? You know, that made me hear your footsteps." And Bilal radiallahu anhu, he said, "I don't really do anything different, but I when I make my wudu, you know, I pray two rak'ah of sunnah prayer or nafil prayers after it." And the Prophet said, "That is it. That's the reason why I can hear your footsteps in paradise, subhanallah." So think of something that you can do that will give you the entry towards paradise because you're doing it sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us learn many, many lessons from these great heroes of Islam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all be companions of these great heroes in paradise. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins and elevate our status and gather us all in Jannatul Firdaus. Wa jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.